defense seems to have tightened up the last 2 games. What are you seeing from that end?
It's 2 games out of a million. I wouldn't jump on anything.
Here comes the different rotations, different players, you know, their ability to adapt. Just talk about that. I mean, I know they have to, but it seems like they've been able to.
Yeah, there's not much choice. Whoever's available plays. It's not a, you know, a conundrum. It's just a fact.
What advice would you give Steven Silas or any coach who's coaching a really young team?
The same advice I give myself. Just patience, set the standards, make people accountable, teach.
How has the patience part of that gone? Do you have to remind yourself, or does it come naturally at this point of the season?
No, you know, when you've got, you know, 19-year-olds that went to college for 1 year and probably the whole year thought about going to the NBA. They probably didn't pay a whole lot of attention anyway. So you know you're at the beginning. And it's real easy to skip steps if you don't have patience because you want to get to step B, C, D, E. You know, you can't do that. So patience is probably the biggest factor in making sure that you stay on a timeline so that you don't leave anybody behind.
You look at some of those faces, it's easy to remember they're 19.
Yeah, well, even the 25-year-olds look like they're 19 to me.
What do you guys like about Sandro?
I have no idea.
Seem like
I just coach whoever walks in the gym. Not my job.
Red's tribute the other day seemed like it was great tribute to his life. Just what are your thoughts on how it went and going through it?
It was a great event for a great man.